Because I was given the impression that the patrons here who are distributed, who comes from different states, would be concentrating on the subject as to how we should take the subject to the masses. But it was a surprise that Shahina comes here and it electrifies every one of us. That is really a great thing for me. And I also happened to meet Leelaji Babu Garu, and of course Ratan Raju is there, and the founder member who is the strength behind, Sultan Ali, is there, and all the patrons, all his team is there. And for the first time I find that in South India at least, we have many organizations in North India which I see, and we also find now several organizations internationally who concentrate, to my experience, I have seen them concentrating for publicity for themselves. I have seen many organizations. I have seen organizations from Malaysia. I have seen organizations from all neighboring countries, including Ceylon. And recently, South India, this South Asia conference took place in Delhi, where the Prime Minister attended, and a message was sent. Representative of United Nations also participated. What I find them in was a five-star culture. Five-star culture is supposed to address the issues only for themselves, and they don't address the issues to the common man. That is the great distinction I find whenever I come to AASRAA's functions. First time last year, as Sultan was saying, I attended the 2K run organized by them at Vishakhapatnam. Honestly, I should say, I was not so much impressed that what could be this 2K run would be. But then I found that once we were on the field, we found many people participating, many children participating, and many dignitaries also participating in the event. What I say is, when you have an organization with a motto, with an object, that something should be done in the field, then you should go into the masses. You should address the target group, the group for which this law is meant. Then only you achieve the object. That is the distinction I found when I went to that function. And today, of course, once again, most of you are here, and then many more have participated, have come from district, different states with the same zeal. Now, yesterday, when Sultan met me, he told me that the audience should be a mixture of different fields. Namely, there are advocates, there are people from industry, there are people from various other professions, but the common goal is the consumer. That's what he told me. And I find that enthusiasm in this gathering. Now, I would say that honestly, when I took up my assignment as the president, I was not very much aware of what consumerism in India, what consumerism as a whole, as a subject. Honestly, I was not aware. But once I step into this, when I started seeing the problems that came before me, I started realizing that consumerism is the most important subject, more important than any other law. I tell you, with my experience, I tell you that if the corporate bodies who are so influential have got their own lobbies to influence even the legislation, this is the only law which they are afraid. They are not afraid of corporate law. They are not afraid of the income tax law. They are not afraid of any other economic laws, namely the FEMA or any other law, not even Money Laundering Act. They are not afraid. But they are very much afraid of this consumer law, because their business is based on consumer. Their business is based on the product they produce, the services they render. But once there is a blow to this product or service, then they are wiped out from the field. That is where they are afraid. We have got the experience. Every one of us know what happened when this noodle issue took place. Maggie issue came that shook the entire country, not only the country, it shook the entire international business for that. There was an occasion where it should have closed, wound up its business and gone. But then they could do something with the lobby they have. I'm sure every one of you know that these corporate bodies, they are instrumental in formulating the legislation to suit their convenience. Whatever you propose, you can be certain about it that there should be some loophole into how there should be an escaping route for them. That is how they do it. Now, this Maggie did not allow a common consumer to approach any consumer court, but then they shifted their concentration elsewhere, the power lobby. They did something there, and then the entire thing is wiped out. I know it is all cosmetic, we know what they do it. For years together, for decades together, you marketed this product which was harmful, which was proven to be harmful. There is no doubt about it. They admitted it. At one stage, they also said, yes, this particular content was really not very good for the health, one particular content. They agreed it. That it was above the normal standards. They admitted it. But then they said, we will once again go to a lab. We'll get the report. We'll get the analysis. We'll see what it is. Then they said, we'll reduce it. Once you say that you reduce it, that means at one point of time, it was more than the standard, prescribed standards. Now the entire scene shifted elsewhere. The power corridors were there. Then they could do something, came back with the same this thing after just about 3 months gap. I was really expecting, I also told some of the friends who met me, I told them that at one point of time, I was expecting explosion of the cases before us, because everybody is a consumer, and everybody who has children in their home definitely have this product. So I was expecting that there will be a lot of explosion in our cases, and then we'll have to cope up with the type of litigation that we are going to get. But then it just blown off like that. It just blown off like that. That is how this law, in a way, could not be implemented in the manner which it should have been implemented. Now, if you see this Consumer Protection Act, 1986, of course, it was the leading enactment at that point of time. Before that, there was no law. And though the United States formulated this law in 1965, after a great deal of efforts by the activists there, then there were some loopholes. Then the matter was taken up by the United Nations. United Nations thought that this was a proper situation where the law could be enacted across the borders of each state. Several countries are there. They enlisted the membership of all the countries, formulated guidelines. They said these are the minimum guidelines which should be prescribed. That is how that took a form of law. And of course, India is one of the foremost country to adopt this particular law. Now, with your experience, with the experience of all the judges who are concerned with this, and then with the experience of the consumers themselves, we find several loopholes in the Act. You have seen that. The most important being that when you pass a judgment, you have no power to implement it. That is the greatest drawback in that law. When you don't implement a law, that law is no law at all. That is why we always say that in India at least, if it takes 5 years or 10 years for you to obtain a decree from a court, if you succeed in a suit, much more time it takes for implementation of that execution. The most difficult part in our country is the execution of a judgment. Judgment is taken today, it takes 10 more years, 20 more years for execution. I know that there is a great saying in that. In other countries, I have seen, at least I visited some neighboring countries, mostly Asian countries, Middle East countries. There, the easiest part of implementation of a judgment is the execution. Unlike our case, we are rewards. What they do is, suppose a money decree is passed, they go to that defendant, the law, the judgment itself says 2 months or 3 months, whatever is the law, according to their law, they set up, they stipulate the time within which it should be done. Then if it is not done, one notice, number two notice, number three notice, no notice, straight away that man will be lifted, put in the prison, civil prison. Then state will not maintain him. He should maintain himself, not one rupee will be spent on him, he should be there. No sentence saying that this is the period of sentence or nothing like that. They say, as soon as you make the payment, get out. If you pay the payment today, midnight, make the payment and get out. There is no time limit for that. If you don't pay, nothing will be done. And at the same time, what they do is, they transmit this decree to every authority in that particular country. Say municipalities or airports, every bank, they send it. So that they also say, they give a direction that you freeze this account. If there is an account, freeze it. If there is a property, freeze it. Don't allow any transaction over the property or the account. That's what they do it. So the most difficult part in our country is the implementation. There are several laws, as Swami was saying, that nobody need think that there is no law in this country. There is law in it. Every sphere of activity, there is a law. There are about 6,000 laws, acts passed by the parliament, and equal number of acts passed by each state government, and much more number of bylaws or rules and regulations by corporations, cooperative societies like that. But what is lacking is the difficulty in implementing it. There is no implementation. Now, Swami was saying that after the district forum, Swami was saying that after the district forum passed this order, at one point of time, he also felt very happy to implement it, because he must have been one of the victims in a theater. He should have gone with his family and thought, why I should spend more. And then he must have been a victim, so he wanted to implement it. But then there was some reason for him not to implement. It has taken a back step. Namely, some Supreme Court judgment, there is an order pertaining to a particular case. They entertained a doubt whether they treat upon the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court. Why to invite embarrassment from the Supreme? That should have been one of the aspects why they have stepped it. But what is the effect of the interim order of the Supreme Court? They could take a legal advice, come to a proper conclusion. What that judgment, that order would bind them in a different case, which has been rendered on a different aspect of the matter. That they could always take a opinion, legal opinion. They can proceed, and in that event, they would not be treating upon the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court. It's not like that. Now, if you come to the consumer education, if you can achieve all these things. If you read the United Nations guidelines, which were given in the last year, 2017, or latest in 2018, they have covered every aspect of the consumer law. They have given required directions to each state how to improve not only the enactment of law, but also the solution of these problems, how to implement it. They have classified. They said the first important person who should take care of this law is consumer by himself. He is the concerned person. He should know his rights. Consumer should know what the law is. Consumer should know what his weaknesses are. Consumer should know that he is paying the money and he wants the value back for the amount which he paid for the particular product. This is the most important aspect which the United Nations said, first be aware of yourself. Know what you know. Know the product, know your rights, because you are losing your purse. The second important things they emphasized is upon the business houses. They said, you can't survive with him. Without him, you can't going to survive. You are producing the product, of course, you do it. But then, if you want to survive in the field, conduct yourself. How to conduct yourself? you conduct yourself according to the business practices, according to the business principles, according to ethics and morality. They said like that. These are the things which should govern a business house. Number three, the most important another aspect is, they said, all right, there is a gentleman called consumer, there is another gentleman called a businessman, and then what is the guarantee for that gentleman or this gentleman? The third gentleman should be the government itself. They said, you are there, you should supervise, you are the overseer, you should see and implement the best of it and see that law is implemented by this business house. So you should play a role. So these are the three important organs which the United Nations said, that consumer by himself, the business by itself, and then the government, which should be the authority to implement and see that this law is implemented in letter and spirit. This is the most important things they covered. How they do it, they have given other, which we need not go into this at that particular point of time. So what I state before is this, that when you have gathered here, these are the three important targets in the consumer education. You should have a target saying that, yes, as much as interest I take, that when I go to a shop and purchase something, or when I go to a particular service provider and avail his service, what are my rights? You know that. If there is a defect in the goods, if there is a defect in the service, all right, I catch hold of him. But as much as you feel, the same feeling you should be able to transform and transfer it to your neighbor who is also a consumer. This is the basic approach which every one of you, all the patrons of AASRAA, should learn. This is the most important thing. Then the task is not so easy. If you think that if you are educating the neighbor, that means you are instigating somebody against the business house. If you are teaching something law, you are instigating this man against the government, because you are telling them his rights. You are asking him not only that you should fight, but you are teaching him to fight and instigating, abetting the crime. Nowadays it has become a fashion. Whatever you say is not the only crime, but if you stand by his side also is a crime. It is an offense. That is how things are taking place now, nowadays. This, it has taken a total different turn. So like that, when you say that this is the kind of thing available, now you should instigate him to fight against the business house, instigate him to fight against the government. And that is where another law comes into, another effort should be made by you, that first of all, you should aware of your rights. What are the laws that go into this Consumer Protection Act? There is an impression, we always think that Consumer Protection Act, all right, 40 or 20 or 35 sections are there, is a small book, doesn't matter. Whatever they write, whatever judgment they render, they just go on multiplying under the same section. So the law itself is so much, it's a small act. That's what you think about it. But it's not like that. Consumer Protection Act is the basic act into which several other acts interplay. Supposing you are purchasing a good, that itself is a contract. You say that I want to purchase it, what's your offer? He says, my offer is 100 rupees. You say, my offer is 90 rupees. All right. There is an agreement, purchase it, it becomes a contract. So that contract is regulated by Contract Act. Now there should be a guarantee, warranty for that. Then there is a specific relief. You should have a specific relief remedy. So specific relief act comes into force. You interact with the financial houses, banks, you deal with that. Then the banking law, you should know it. Then the interest part of it, interest law, you should know it. So on and so forth, everything. Insurance law, nowadays, every one of must have experience. The catchword for them is that fraud is played by the policyholder, by the insured. What they do is, when the agent comes to you, he comes to you with a bouquet, with a garland, and he says, oh no, this is a beautiful policy, wonderful policy, you will become a lakh year, multi-millionaire, this thing, that thing, purchase it, he'll bring a sweet pocket and everything is over. If God forbids, if something happens to that insured person, then the real problem starts for the successor or the inheritor. he goes with this policy or she goes with the policy or the child goes with this policy and ask them, please pay back my money which my father has invested. He says, no, no, your father has played fraud on us. What is that fraud? He went to some hospital, he had taken treatment that he did not disclose. What is the treatment? He was suffering with BP. Many cases have come up. He was suffering with BP. Which is that person on earth now without BP? Can we conceive any person there without a BP? Recently also we came across a case where LIC was fighting with that case. I asked them, see, there are a quite number of people, advocates are also here. You are also pleading for the LIC. Tell me, are you free from BP? What is BP? It's a disorder because of lifestyles. Present lifestyles are different. Of course, those days, 40 years or 50 years, one used to hear BP and something like that. But of course, nowadays, even at 25 years by, has got all the ailments because what we learnt is, they're sitting there and doing something going on the systems. So that is how BP is supposed to be a suppression, and then they say, no, you get out. Then other thing they say, no, you had another wonderful disease which you didn't disclose. What this investigator does is, he is appointed to find out whether this so-called ailment is bad or woman correct or not. This man somehow goes to that village. He says he has gone to the village, goes to the village, catches hold of the widow or children. They happen to be illiterates. Then they ask him, what was your husband? The widow says, he was doing cultivation. This man told me he was doing some business and now you are saying cultivation. Then he says, no, business was all, business means not a big business. He used to purchase local and then sell it, perhaps he said it. No, what you say is, this is also not correct. Then all sorts of questions. You will wonder, these investigators even go to medical shops. They go to medical shops and ask him whether so-and-so has purchased medicine at any point of time, as if he remembers. How can a medical shop man who gives medicine across even without prescription, he says, did you sell any medicine? Did he purchase this medicine from you? And God alone knows what he says. So this is the type, this is the extent of this thing these companies are going. Now this motive is only one thing. When you sell it, you are a good man. When you want to distribute the benefit, you become so non-great. That is the whole problem. So what our experience tells is that in case, I'll give one example so that the entire field, how the education is very important, awareness is important. There was a very wonderful man in our Vishakhapatnam. He knows law. Vishakhapatnam, he knows, this agent knows this insurance law. What he did was, he disclosed everything about his client. He had some BP, he disclosed BP, he has disclosed it, and there was kind of some kind of an ailment which otherwise would have attracted more premium amount. He disclosed that. Then within few months, two or three months, that man died because he was expected to die soon. That is how the policy was purchased. See, it's an investment. It was an investment. Investment cannot wait for long. So immediate returns, he planned it. This man will go within 3 months. He planned it, said it, disclosed it in the proposal form, paid the premium, and God has taken him over. Now claim was filed. As usual, these investigators got into the field and then made search. They said, it's operation and all that, this thing, that thing. And now there, what this agent did was, he had the blessings of somebody who should be sanctioning this. He got it rejected. Claim was rejected because they don't want to take the burden on their heads. So you ask him, you just reject it. They'll go to court. Got it rejected. Then automatically, he knows that consumer court is the best court for this. came before me. Then the advocate gets up and says, sir, you just take up the proposal form, you just take up the investigation report, you just take up the rejection letter, you just compare them. Then I found what all he made an allegation is available here, what all he said is available here. So what is the suppression? Then it came to light that there was a collusion between the agent, the person who sanctioned it, and the person who suffered this ailment, and it was a 50 lakh policy. It was a 50 lakh policy, 50 lakh rupees gone, appeal can't be filed because it's based on fact. There is no interpretation of law. Facts are there. Then you can just imagine what could be the amount that family or the insured would have got it. Because everything is played in by others. This man is important, that man is important, elsewhere it is important. So what is unimportant is this man. So you can understand what could have happened. So why I am saying is this, that a person who knows the law, a person who knows the practical things alone can have the benefit, and also a benefit of this type also. This will legally, whatever it is. And we can't say he's wrong because he disclosed it. It is for you, whether you have given it or not. So what I take this opportunity that you being the youngsters and attracted to this subject, that is most important. Dedication is most important. Shaina said, not only my father, but I see a dedicated team with him, without whom it's not possible at all. And what she said is 100% correct. Without a dedicated team, nothing can be achieved. Nothing can be achieved. And whatever I yell, I may stand on the roof of a top and then say, oh, this is the thing. But who is there to listen unless somebody carries this message to elsewhere? Even in the greatest of prophets, prophets could not become prophets only because they are prophets. Yeah. Prophets became prophets because their followers could take the message. So I am very glad that second time a chance is given to me to address you, mostly about the consumer protection and how the practically it should be approached, how it should be implemented now that you know the importance of law. And what I want to say is there is a lot of departure in the new act that is going to come, Bill 2018. There's a lot of thing. And if you read that law also, you will find that there are some drawbacks. I should call it drawbacks at this stage. Perhaps they want to protect class litigation from going to courts. And at one point of there was a discussion about this at the national conference where Justice D.K. Jain, the former president of the National Commission, I also participated. And then there was a discussion, both of us also participated. We had our own views on that. We said, by introducing this class legislation, what are you doing? You are depriving the consumer courts from entertaining these disputes. You are bypassing. What you did in Maggie's case, now you are turning it, converting it into law. That there was no law there. When Maggie happened, there was no law. Now Maggie was a lesson for you. Maggie has given you a chance to enact a law, to depart from the normal procedure, take the litigation in your hands, and keep the lobbies under your control or a channel for interaction with them, with the multinationals. That is one departure they have made, which we are much very, very much opposed to that. Aggrieved part should straight away come to court. But the ministry was saying, all right, suppose we fail, what will happen? You are the only resort. We say, where is the question of you failing or my filing? Suppose, see, just like our MRP's case, who is the customer? Who is the person who can make a issue of that? There are multitudes of people, hundreds of people every day visit the theaters or hotels or whatever it is. Can you expect these people to have a litigation like this? So what happens to us? And now, our Madhara has awarded the cost also, commensurate with the type of standards of that this thing. Now supposing he wants this compensation to go to those customers, is it possible? They are unorganized. They come, they spend, all right, is a very good picture or bad picture, they make comment and they vanish. But how to distribute this amount? So that is the greatest thing. So that way, these business houses, this class litigation will be complete diversion. You can't distribute. Suppose Maggie had happened, Maggie had caused damage. Fortunately, nothing had happened. If something had happened, Bhopal, we know, Bhopal gas in 1987, what happened? Even now that effect is there. Where is the compensation? How much compensation you said? You shell down a mere compensation of about 700 crores at that point of time, 700 crores, for a compromise not only on the civil side of payment, but even on the criminal side. What happened? You excused that man, carbide chairman, allowed him to flee away from the country. You allowed this compensation to be distributed among 2,000 immediate victims and more than that, the later victims because of the effects later effects of this gas explosion. You allowed a paltry sum of about 700 crores, 720 crores, something like that. Now, who stood the benefit of it? The man who caused this destruction, he was given an excuse even on the criminal side. He was allowed. No criminal law, that's a compromise. Killing for a bargain, transfer of money, that man has gone. He escaped. So that is how there is a kind of loophole in this act also where the litigation is diverted from the regular courts to what is called the class litigation to be dealt with by commissioner, whatever name they have given, some authority they have created, like that. It goes like that. Then ultimately, God alone knows whether it comes back to us or not. That is how the courts should exercise. Court should know whether, in spite of that class litigation, whether we can entertain these cases or not. This is a different thing. That is where the consumer activists also come into picture. Why should I go to government? I'll go to court. You can test it. So these are the various things. So what I place before you is that this is the best platform for you, and you have got all the enthusiasm of not only learning what the law is, not only how to implement it, and then with the same enthusiasm, you should march forward and see that something is done. And I tell you one thing, that the so-called cosmetic or five-star type of organizations elsewhere, they attract immediate attention, you see. What happens is, if you are showy, if you speak flowery these things, you attract the attention, but it's not solution. And I told even Sultan also, see, there are some organizations which pose themselves as very best organizations. They come on the channels, they exclaim so many things and all that, but they do nothing. But the organizations which are there at the grassroots levels must come forward. And I think this is one of the best platform at the root level. And every one of you should not only learn, and today Divakar Babu has given the entire this thing, scenario, so that improve it. Learning is a process. Every day you learn better. Keep it informed. Go to the target groups. Target groups might be students. Target groups might be industrialists. Target groups might be unorganized consumer. Whatever you choose, you go to them, teach law, and you'll certainly have the effect, if not immediately, in about say 5 years or 10 years, whatever it is, you will have the best consumerism in India. With this, I thank every one of you for having heard me, and more so, every one of you, I think not only every one of you is an organizer here, because you have wholeheartedly participated in this. Not only Sultan is, according to me, is only a coordinator. He has coordinated you, and every one of you is a participant, as an organizer, and our Swami is here, and Damodar, their boss should have come, and the Swami is there, he is equally interested, he is just opposite me in the premises, we can catch hold of him, no problem, anytime we can. Now in this case also, Madhura's case also, Swami is my respondent, they are bound to respond, we will catch hold of him, no problem, we will see that law is implemented, our part we row, we'll definitely discharge. Please do your duties perfectly so that there will be improvement. When we happen to meet next year, show me improvement. Thank you so much.